I will talk about Hamilton's principle and derivation of Lagrange's equation of motion using this, right? So and for this I will use the calculus of variation. And what do we do? We have to find the path, means when a particle is moving from one point to another point. Say there is a particle somewhere in space and say it is x-axis and it is y-axis. Sorry, not x-axis, but because it's a time. It's a time coordinate because I'm considering a dynamic system. So that means something is changing with time. And say it is the generalized coordinate and QT, right? So particle is moving from A point to B point. It may either follow this path or it may follow this path or any path in between these two, any path, it may go from anywhere. So it is A and B. So particle wants to reach from A point to the B point, and there are so many possible paths. One path is this. This is for this, it is QT, and for it is QT, sorry, it's QT plus delta T, sorry, Q plus delta Q. There is change in it, as we have did in the earlier case, delta Y, right? It's similar to that. Means it may go from A to B either following a path ACB, or it may follow a path AC prime B. Which path it must follow? The particle must follow the path for which action is least. Action is least. And this is known as Hamilton's principle of least action. So let me express in proper words. A particle is represented by Lagrangian. Another thing which we have to keep in mind, that particle is represented by the Lagrangian. Lagrangian means a term containing both kinetic as well as potential energy. It's basically kinetic minus potential energy, or in other words, I can say that Lagrangian is containing the information of the energy of the system. So that means there are various possible paths along which a dynamical system may move from one point A, let us call it is A, to another point B, point P, with a specified time interval. The actual path followed is that which minimizes the time integral, which minimizes the time integral of the Lagrangian. Or in other words, I can say that say that action integral must be least. Action integral must be least, right? So let us, that is delta S must be equal to 0, and this is nothing but this is the principle of least action or Hamilton's principle of least action, right? So mathematically, Lagrangian is defined as, let us try to look at mathematically, Lagrangian we have defined as Qt, Q dot T and T, right? That is the Lagrangian which we have defined. And in terms of Lagrangian, action can be represented as its integral, sorry, action is defined as, mathematically, action is integral of Lagrangian over a time interval t naught to t1. So this is action, and according to Hamilton's principle, action must be least. Action must be least. So delta s jo hoga, it must be least. Ye zero hona chahiye, right? So that means, say, let us consider two paths, as I did here. I have chosen a path A C prime B. For this path, let us call Lagrangian. And Lagrangian for this is Q prime T, Q dot prime T, and T. And for this action is S prime, and this action is T naught to T1. Lagrangian Q prime T, Q dot delta, Q dot prime T and T dt. And for another path, because we are having two paths ACB, so for this Lagrangian is QT, Q dot T and T. And for this action is basically T naught to T1, its integral. It is QT, Q prime T and T dt. This is 1 and this is 2. And what is delta S? According to principle of least action, delta S is basically the difference of these two. So delta S is equal to S prime minus S. So it is integral T naught to T1, Q prime T dot into T dt minus it is T naught to T1, because initial and final times are remains the same. Time interval will not change, right? So it is Lagrangian QT and Q dot T and T. So that means there is a slight change in the path. Q plus delta Q, as we have did in the diagram. So from that, I can express this as, it is integral T naught to T1, Lagrangian, Q plus delta Q, comma, Q dot plus delta Q dot, comma T. This is its extension, into dt minus T naught to T1, Lagrangian Q comma Q dot comma T dt. And it's a change, slight change. So when there is a change in something, that means we can apply a Taylor's expansion, and I am expanding it only up to the first. So if I apply Lagrangian, if I expand this using Taylor expansion, then what can be obtained? It is it is t naught to t1 Lagrangian q, q dot t minus, sorry, plus curly L over curly q delta q plus curly L over curly q dot delta q dot, ये इसकी expansion आ गई, right? Minus, this will remain as it is, L q q dot t. And overall, dt, this will cancel out with it. So, what is delta S? This is the value of delta S. So, delta S can be written as integral T naught to T1, curly L over curly Q, delta Q plus curly L over curly Q dot, delta Q dot into dt. Or it is T naught to T1, curly L over curly Q, delta Q dt plus T naught to T1, curly L over curly Q dot, delta Q dot into dt. Now expanding this part binomially, integrating this by parts. So if I integrate it by parts, only this part, then what I am getting, it is dt, this second part, it is curly L over curly Q dot, delta Q dot into dt, it's integral from T naught to T1, and let me re-express it as curly L over curly Q dot, it is delta Q dot, and Q dot is what? Delta Q dot means its derivative with respect to time. So it is d upon dt into delta Q, right? Into dt. It's integral from T naught to T1 because it is the derivative of delta Q. Dot means that with respect to time. So ye mere paas aa jata hai. Now expanding it. So it is curly L over curly Q dot. First function as it is integral of second function, right? And it's integral from T naught to T1. This will cancel out with it minus d upon dt, curly L over curly Q dot, integral d upon dt, delta Q into dt, and whole integral, it is from T naught to T1. और ये वाला पार्ट क्या हो जाएगा, दिस विल बी इक्वल टू जीरो बिकॉज ये कैंसिल हो गया. एंड व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ डेल्टा क्यू एट टी नॉट एंड टी वन, इक्वल टू जीरो, देर इज नो चेंज एट द एक्सट्रीम एंड, राइट? सो दैट मीन्स दिस विल बिकम जीरो, सो वी विल रिमेन ओनली विद दिस पार्ट एंड दिस विल कैंसिल आउट विद इट एज वी डिड इन द अर्लियर लेक्चर. सो आई विल पुट इट दिस वैल्यू हियर इन दिस. So, what it will become now, this is equal to this delta S will be equal to, it is curly L over curly Q delta Q, its integral into dt and integral from T0 to T1 minus d upon dt, curly L over curly Q dot delta Q, it is delta Q, it's integral from T naught to T1 and dt. And let us rearrange this, and if we club these two, so it is curly L over curly Q minus d upon dt, curly L over curly Q dot, and delta q into dt and integral from t naught to t1. When the action will be least, for the least action, delta s must be equal to 0. That means this part must be equal to 0, and this is possible if and only if this integrand part, this is equal to 0. Ye integral kab banish hoga, means action kab least hoga, when this integrand will be equal to 0. So I can write down, for delta s to become 0, this curly L over curly Q minus D upon dt, curly L over curly Q dot, it is equal to 0. And what is this? This is Lagrange's equation of motion. So that means we have used the idea of calculus of variation to find out the least action, and that principle of least action is Hamilton's principle, and using that Hamilton's principle means equating action, change in action must be equal to 0, we have obtained the Lagrange's equation of motion. So that's all for this lecture.